of a big monkey man. I never saw you.
Morning, everybody. Now, I didn't get a chance to go out at the weekend because it was absolutely tipping it down with rain, thundering, lightning, all that kind of stuff. So it's Monday today, and I've decided to come into this forest, which is literally at the end of the lane that I live on. I mean, it's absolutely huge. Now, I don't know what kind of activity there was in here in the past, if any, I don't know. I don't normally come in here because it's usually got lots of people walking the dogs and stuff like that, but it's very quiet today. So, we'll have a look round here and see if we can turn anything up. Now, I have noticed a lot of tin cans, bottles, that kind of stuff, so obviously the youngsters come in here partying and boozing and what have you. So anyway, we'll see what we can find, and I'll catch you on the first decent signal that we get. Okay, see you in a bit. Well, boys and girls, this is literally the first signal that I got. I haven't got a clue what it is. I don't know. There must be some brass or copper in it somewhere, because it gave a really good signal, but just looks like a load of rubbish, whatever it is. So I'll not be carrying that out with me. I'll just rebury it. Okie dokie. See you on the next signal. Well, next signal, not actually surprised really to what's left of a shotgun shell. It might be quite old. I'll see if I can clean it up a little bit and see if I can get a maker's name off it. Alright, see you in a bit. Well, much to my surprise, I've just dug this plug out here. It's only about 4 inches, 5 inches deep. And I've just turned a coin up just there. And I think it's an old threepenny bit. I'm very surprised. I honestly didn't expect to find a decent coin as soon as this, but excuse me, I can't see the date on it or anything like that. I mean, I can't even see the person's head. But we'll have a look in a bit and see who it is and how old it is. Okay, see you in a bit. Right, we've got a decent signal down here. It's coming up at about 45 on the scale. It says it's only about 4 inches deep, so we'll give it a dig together and see what we've got. Okay, I'll see you in a minute. Right, detector says it's just down there somewhere, so let's give it a dig and see what we've got. I can see it now. It's just an old buckle, an old belt buckle. See that? Only about 4 inches deep, maybe 5 inches, something like that. Just an old belt buckle, but it's another nice little find. So we'll pop that away, fill the hole in, and move on in that direction. Okie dokie. Well, next signal, boys and girls. Cracking signal, came up about 80. Oh, there we go, just what's left of a tin can. I'm not surprised, really. I thought I'd have found more than that before now, to be honest with you. But that's RMD keeping the faith. See you in a while. Ah, well, I had to find one sooner or later, didn't I? Bottle top, which is why I've got my gloves on. I mean, I haven't come across any glass yet, but I'm sure there's plenty down here. Don't know what they've been drinking. Might be sherry. Number 8. Something like that. Okie dokie. I'll catch you in a bit. Alright, boys and girls. We've got another signal down here. It came up at about 74 on the scale. Once again, it's only about 4 inches, 5 inches deep. I don't know whether you can see that, but it's just... hold on, it's just there, just see it underneath, in between that, in that little crack there. It's another coin. It's a little silver coin. it's got a rabbit on it. Okay, what on earth is that? It's either a rabbit or a hare. Oh, hold on a minute, on the other side it's got a harp, so I assume it's Irish. I can just about see the date. I think it says 1949, but strangely enough it hasn't got one of our monarch's heads on it. Why that is, I don't know, but obviously some kind of little silver Irish coin. So, well, that's a nice little find. I've never found one with a rabbit on before. Right, I'll see you in a bit. Right, boys and girls, we've got another signal down here. I think it's still in the plug. I'll let you have a listen to it. Shit, that. Here we go. Right, it's coming up at 69 on the scale. So, let's have a look and see what we've got this time. Another mystery object. It looks like a lion's foot. Have a look. You see that? Looks like a lion's foot. Maybe it's off an old drawer. You know, a drawer or something like that. Well, that's what it is. It's a lion's foot. Okie dokie, right, we'll fill the hole in and see what we can find next. Well, actually, I'm just about ready for packing up now, to be honest with you. Look at that, you never know I'd been there. Right, boys and girls, I've had enough today. So, we haven't found an awful lot, but we found a couple of nice bits and pieces. That first thing we dug up, that whatever it was, big steel thing with teeth on it and whatever, I reburied that. I don't know what it were. I've dug quite a few of these up, bottle caps. This one says number 8, matured for 8 years in oak, so presumably it was sherry or something like that. Dug the belt buckle up. Well, I'm assuming it's a belt buckle and not off a horse. Don't know how old that is. Then we dug this shotgun shell up. I cleaned it up a little bit, and the only word that I can read on it says London. So it's obviously not a local make of shotgun cartridge. Maybe it was some, I don't know, landed gentry up this part of the country on a posh shoot or something in these woods. I don't really know. Anyway, that was that. And we've just dug this up, which I still think looks like a lion's foot, or some kind of animal's foot. It's got a little, I don't know if you can see, it's got a little hole in the top. I don't know whether it was pinned onto something. Maybe, as I said, it's off an old drawer front, or a, I don't know. It's a lion's foot anyway. And then we dug this up, which is an old English threepenny bit. It's got, I think the thistles on it, and the date on that is 1943. So that is Edward the somebody. You can see him on back there. And then we dug this little silver coin up, which is a lovely little coin, but it's got a hare on it, a hare with big ears. Can you see that? A hare with big ears. And a harp on the other side. As I said, it's not got one of our monarch's heads on it. Why that is, I don't know. And it says 3D on it, so I'm presuming it's a threepenny piece. The date on that is 1949. And it's got some writing on it, which I can't pronounce because it's in Irish. Is it Celtic or something like that? Anyway, I'll put a couple of photos in the video when I put it together later on today. And I'll post it today. So anyway, thanks for joining me. It's been nice to have you with me again. Just want to give a quick shout out to a Japanese guy called Wink Mirror. He leaves me some lovely comments. I can't understand much of what he's saying. He does a lot of translations and stuff. But the place where he detects in Japan, in the mountains, the scenery is beautiful. As long as you can put up with the snakes, the bears, and apparently the bandits that want to kill you and shoot you. No, I'm having none of that. Anyway, thanks for joining me. I'll see you all later. Bye-bye. Whether you whine or grine, whether you whine or grine, she shake it up right on time.
brush. If you have your brush, you can avoid the rush.